a specific drill we're going to talk about doing, where we teach the young dogs to be redirected before we need to redirect them in the world, right? And we have several kinds of redirection. We have the type where we're redirecting the dog off of things I don't want them to play with or chew on, right? So if my dog's in the living room and it picks up my shoe and I'd rather he doesn't chew up my shoe, I redirect him off of my shoe onto a bone or something. So I grab the shoe and I say, look what I've got. He transfers off that, I give him this, I put my shoe up, and now he has something else. I say, how about not that thing, how about this thing, right? And we just basically swap out. I redirect when the puppies are mouthing me. I keep a toy or food on me and the puppy wants to bite my pant leg, I stop moving and I redirect their energy onto a toy. And then we have redirection as it pertains to socialization and management out in the world, right? And this is a big one, right? So if I have my young puppy out and I'm going for a walk across the parking lot and my puppy sees another dog coming, and my puppy's maybe a little anxious about new dogs, or it's a big dog like it's never seen, and my puppy wants to go out on the end of the leash and start woofing at the other dog, right? This is something I'd prefer they not practice, right? I want to say, oh, hey, I don't want you to learn to be at the end of the leash barking at other dogs or other people. And so I redirect my dog's energy into some other activity so they can forget about that, right? And I can redirect them when they start doing it, or ideally, I redirect them before they have a chance to, right? And so if I know the first couple of times your puppy does something like this, you're going to be surprised. You may not be expecting your puppy to woof at the other dog that's coming towards you or that person walking down the street. But once your puppy does it once, you should say, oh, my puppy may have a propensity to do that in the right circumstance. And so that at that point, I want to become preemptive. So before my puppy has a chance, my puppy notices the dog coming and I go, hey, pup, and I get my dog to turn away from it and I reward the dog for turning away from it and I start channeling it into some other activity, whether it's food usually in the beginning or a toy. And so at that point they noticed it or didn't notice it and I channeled their energy in a different direction so they didn't get the opportunity to rehearse what I don't want them to rehearse in this case, right? And then as they get older and they get more comfortable, they're less likely to do that. They haven't had a chance to practice that. The later you are with your redirection, the harder it is. If you wait till your puppy's out at the end of the leash, barking its head off, and then you say, puppy, come on, your puppy's like, no, I'm focused, right? The other thing is dogs on harnesses, if you're walking your puppy around on a harness, are harder to redirect, right? Because they feel that harness, they lean into it, now they want to go forward, you're trying to pull them, they want to go the other way more, and because we do restraint and things on harnesses for restrained recalls and restrained play, they can get fired up when you're holding them back on a harness, and so they can be harder to redirect. So when you're walking puppies around on harnesses, it's even more important that you be preemptive, that you redirect them before they have a chance to get fixated on something in the environment. And generally speaking, if you have a young puppy, you don't want to sit there and let them watch stuff that's active out there. Don't just sit there and let them stare at stuff that's going on. That's where they decide to go off, right? So if I sit there with my dog and somebody's out on the field throwing the ball for their dog and my puppy's watching and I just stand there and hold my puppy back and let my puppy watch that, that's very quickly going to turn into my puppy lunging and barking and everything else. He's like, oh, what's that, right? So anytime your puppy's hard staring at something, like, what's that? Maybe it's a good time for you to interrupt that before they have a chance to do something bad. Maybe they won't. But also, that's a good sign that their energy is very fixated in a certain way, and I may say, let's forget about that for now. Let's do this instead.